I am Tamil Rashid, Head of Generative AI Innovation and Delivery at AWS. Join me as I talk to leaders and innovators across Amazon who are using AWS Generative AI to create hyper-personalized experiences for customers, streamline operations, improve productivity, and so much more. Learn more inside Gen AI at Amazon. I'm really excited about today's session. I'm being joined by Mari Yoler. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do at Amazon?
Absolutely. So I am Senior Manager Product at Amazon Music. My team builds AI-powered products for both music and podcasts. For example, last April, we launched Maestro, which is our first foray into Gen AI at music. And it is an AI-powered playlist generation experience where a customer can input the natural language prompt and get a playlist in return. And as an entrepreneur, I've actually been using AI for a long time. My company, Snackable, joined Amazon about 2 years ago, initially to work on podcasts. So we all love listening to podcasts, but as we know, they can be long, and it's sometimes hard to understand what's inside. So the Snackable technology used AI to essentially analyze the audio and pull out those interesting segments, or snacks as we call them, to basically enable customers to preview the podcasts and then ascertain if they wanted to listen for more. And it's really been a stepping stone for the work that I do at Amazon today, which spans podcasts and music and also across voice and visual surfaces.
No, that's great to see. I'm a big fan of listening to music and was really excited to see the announcement of Maestro. Can you tell us a little bit about, you know, more broadly, how the use of generative AI is helping to improve customer experience?
Absolutely. So in music, for example, creating a playlist used to be the purview of just a few. You really had to be a music aficionado or a radio DJ to build the perfect mixtape for somebody. And with generative AI, we're democratizing that. We're really bringing the playlist generation experience to the fingertips of many. So anybody can really create a playlist. For example, on my way over to this interview, I asked Maestro to inspire me for an interview about generative AI. And the resulting track list was very fascinating. It had some futuristic songs like David Bowie's Space Oddity, for example. And so, you know, what we are doing is really using Maestro to bring this completely new interaction paradigm to customers, and it opens up possibilities. And it's been really rewarding to see the reactions from folks when they have this tool at their disposal. When we were launching Maestro, we did some tests with Amazon employees. And I remember somebody really just saying, wow, now I can make a playlist for my family barbecue. And the data backs it up as well. So if we look at the proportion of Maestro-generated playlists as a percentage of overall playlists in our database, we see this number increasing quite quickly. And that really gives us the confidence and satisfaction that we are allowing customers to really tap into the creativity with this new technology.
That's really exciting how you can use natural language to influence the kind of playlist that you want to listen to. I also, on my way here, I was just listening to music as well, too. So we both were doing the same thing. Generative AI has this power to really solve business problems. And, you know, when I talk to customers, there's so many use cases that they think about. As you all were thinking about the usage of generative AI, how were you thinking about it from the perspective of what use cases to enable or what specific business problems to solve?
Sure, that's a really great question. And I would say that Gen AI is really changing how customers expect to find both information and content. And in short, they really expect to interact with this technology using the full range of human expression. So at Amazon Music, we also want customers to interact with us the way they would speak to a friend. And so the way that we're working with the foundational models underneath the hood is really constructing those pieces that help us, one, understand, for example, the customer's intent behind the prompt, match the prompt to the content, and then finally present that content in a way that feels enriching and dynamic to the customer. So we weave that complexity into a seamless, natural interaction paradigm for the customer without them ever seeing that the complexity underneath the hood. And so in music, what it means that it's, I can find and I can refine what I want to listen to. So I could say to Maestro, build me a rock road trip. And so you would get a playlist that has this fun title and also an explanation as to why we've recommended that to you as a customer. So it might say, you know, hit the road with these rockers with of the likes of U2, Nirvana, and others. And in podcasts also, we can really reimagine the discovery experience. So say I was into meditation and I was listening to an episode by 10% Happier. And I thought to myself, well, how could I find other content that talks about meditation? And so I might see then this topic that we've extracted using Gen AI that says meditation. I click on it. And now I land on a page where I see old episodes across our entire catalog, across different shows that talk about meditation. So what we've done is that we've created this kind of horizontal web of connectivity between different pieces of content. And it really transforms how quickly and efficiently customers can discover content that really interests them.
It's remarkable to see how these generative AI applications have a very seamless and simple experience for the end user, and it abstracts all that complexity. Speaking of complexity, could you tell us a little bit about the AWS services that you use to power the application and what sort of drove the selection of those services?
Absolutely. Amazon Bedrock has been a key partner for us as we've been on this innovation journey with generative AI. We've benefited from the variety of foundation models that Bedrock has to experiment, but also to productionalize and also to scale the customer experiences both across music and podcasts. And Bedrock has provided us with the flexibility we've needed on this innovation journey, especially as you know, this technology is evolving very rapidly, whether that is new model versions or capabilities or tools. And we've also benefited from associated capabilities that are available on Bedrock. And one to call out would be trust and safety guardrails to ensure that our customers are able to safely interact with these new services, and also that the generated content then safeguards our customers, but also our artists and creative partners and Amazon brand.
You know, that's so important. I'm glad you mentioned guardrails because as, you know, organizations build these generative AI apps, you know, sort of respecting the data privacy, data security, and ensuring that whatever is generated is actually the right content you want to give to the end user is so important.
Absolutely.
You know, I know it's still early days for what you've all built with Maestro and, you know, more capabilities that you'll have in the future. Are there sort of some immediate benefits you've seen and observed from your customers as they've started interacting with those generative AI solutions?
Yes, absolutely. The one that I am really enthusiastic about is that Gen AI has really allowed our customers to be more creative in a new way in how they interact with music and podcasts. And it's this type of behavior change that's been really fun to watch and to nudge and also see customers nudge the technology themselves. So when the customers first come into Maestro, they might do something very simple, like say Adele or 90s hip hop. But as they see examples and I guess they get more comfortable, they start also pushing on the technology to get more. So they might say things like sunset, you know, cocktails or something like mountain crunchy granola vibes and really lean into that technology. And that's been really fantastic to watch where people take these bolder steps and get more creative. Because we really want people to get any music or podcasts that really suits their in-the-moment listening needs, any whim, any mood, any activity, and it really helps them to get more out of our vast catalog of content. And the other thing that's worth mentioning is that the depth of personalization that we're able to go with Gen AI is really unprecedented. So we don't really tell you anymore that you like rock or U2 or Pink. We tell you that you like powerful female rockers or YouTube ballads or legendary guitar riffs. And that's just a very different level of familiarity or personalization that we can make the experience much more magical for customers.
You know, I have to agree with you. Just being able to use a music-based app with these features, it not only drives more engagement. I mean, I can even say that on a personal level, but you feel this sense of creativity and ownership in the music that you listen to. And so you can really personalize it. So I'm glad you mentioned that because that definitely is something that I've experienced firsthand. You and many other teams at Amazon are trailblazing and adding these Gen AI capabilities into applications. As you've gone through this early experience, what are some key lessons that you've learned throughout the journey in adopting the technology, and then more importantly, scaling it to, you know, millions of users?
Yeah, that's a really great question. And it feels like we just started using the technology and it's been so many learnings. And at the same time, it feels like we're just scratching the surface of this, you know, massive wave that's yet to come. And there's definitely been many learnings. I think perhaps three are worth calling out that are perhaps a bit more unique of we didn't always expect to see. But I would say in the first one is that progress is not always linear. The assumption is that things will get better, and they have massively done so. But sometimes we go backwards, and then we have to tweak a bit. So, for example, we might see that the next version of a model introduces hallucination to our use case, and then it's important for us to always have this quality evaluation data and methods to ensure that we measure and maintain the performance. And the second one, I'd say, is speed and quality. So it's really great to get a solution out of Gen AI that's 80% of the box magical. And I think it's the 20% that's really hard, and that's what everybody is focusing on. And so we are constantly making the quality better and investing in that. And so an example here would be that we are seeing a very popular track, let's say blinding lights by weekend pop up on a variety of playlists. And why is that? Is because it in 2021, it became the Billboard Hot 100 number one song in all of history. And it's interesting because, you know, when it comes to LLMs, they are in essence a product of what they've learned on the internet, and their recommendations are, you know, very, very much influenced by those learnings. So that's something, another interesting learning for us. And I would say the third is trust and safety. And so protecting our brand and customers from potentially harmful or offensive or biased content is crucial. So robust trust and safety controls continue to be our number one priority as we move along in this space.
No, thank you for sharing those lessons. I think those are very important for this audience as they think about those lessons and, you know, kind of building with those things in mind, right? So accuracy of content, but then more importantly, you know, really understanding the impact that wrong things can happen on the brand itself, right? So that's great. Well, I'd like to, you know, kind of close with a final question about what's next. You know, as you plan to expand and enhance your use of generative AI within the application, how are you thinking about that going forward?
I would like to come back with that question to the beginning of our conversation, which was about this great music expert who is this aficionado and can make the perfect mixtape for you. And that's really our vision, is to create this monocle of music, essentially, which is the expert in your pocket who truly knows you, understands you, gets you the right content just when you need it. And it's by combining this great content with its history and its cultural zeitgeist into these foundational models that will then enable to really put that monocle of music in your pocket. And so in terms of how that informs our plans forward, I would say having the variety of models available to us and ways to explore will be key. And so that we can get, for example, the right size models to do the right size tasks. And then we can connect them into this fun, dynamic, and highly personalized experience for our customers.
That's really inspiring. I really want to thank you, Mari, for the time that you spent with us, the information you shared, and the insights as well, too. So thank you.
Thank you for having me. It's a great discussion.